Alright guys, so I'm gonna do my 2019 goals video today. This is gonna be a collab with Elizabeth Ashley. I'll explain more about that later. But I wanted to do something new this year. I normally write down my goals and then I like forget about them or just abandon them, or I don't even know what I do, but by the time December comes around, I have no idea what they were. And just so y'all have proof that that is true, when I went to counseling this week, today is Friday, I went Tuesday, she asked me, well, last time we met, this was 9 months ago, last time we met you had all these goals and you were trying to do these things, how's that going? I was like, to be honest with you, I have no idea what they were. So, onward to 2019. I have no idea if I reached my goals or not. I'm in the process of decluttering, so y'all see those stacks back there in my dresser. That's the stuff I have left that I don't want in my room. So, other than that, it's perfect. Okay, so anyway, back to my 2019 goals. So what I did was I wrote them down all in the front of my planner. I'll show y'all how I broke them down month by month so I can keep myself actually looking at them. Okay, so my first thing I want to do is do one fun thing per quarter. So the first quarter is, which you probably already know because I think I mentioned it more than once, is to get a massage. That's what I want to do for first quarter. Second quarter, I want to go to a concert that's in Birmingham. Third quarter, I was going to Essence Festival, and I decided that that is too expensive. Mainly because, sorry y'all, I'm supposed to be looking at the camera, but I'm looking at myself. Mainly because people book like a year out. And so, even right now, most of the rooms are over $200 a night. So basically, if I wanted to go, I would have to book it like this summer for next summer. So yeah, that's not really gonna work for me. So what I decided to do instead is take a trip to Austin, Texas. That is the plan, that is the goal. But it's not, I'm not sure if it's actually in that quarter. Let's see. Yeah, it will be, because I'm just gonna do it in August instead of July. And then for the last quarter, I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. I'm thinking about maybe doing, maybe a month of yoga classes or a yoga class every other week, something like that. I don't know. So, and a lot of, I actually have been looking for stuff in December next year, but it's so far away, it's kind of hard to, figure out what, like, events and stuff will be going on around that time. So I'll just look, like, closer to then. My second goal, so my deadline, I gave myself deadlines for each one of these goals. So that, for my deadline for the quarter goal is December 2019, obviously because I have to do one per quarter. My second goal is to prioritize my well-being. I do have depression, I do have anxiety, and I have a toddler. So I'm working on... Normally, my mood is not as happy as it is now. So, I'm working on doing natural things to help that, which is why I want to start back doing yoga. I used to do yoga a lot, and I haven't done it in a while now, but it's something that I love doing, and it relaxes me. The next one is to explore new ways to fellowship. Now, normally after church, I'm one of those people that like to get in my car and go home because I got my word. I'm trying to, like, munch on it, you know, digest it. And right now, I'm not attending Bible study at my church for various reasons. But I just need some other way to... interact. Now, even though I don't go to Bible study that we have every Wednesday night, I do go to a women's study class that we have every third Saturday of the month. So I do that. So that's something that's new. Actually, 2018 was the first year we did it. So 2019 will be the second year. I have heard of this new thing they're doing at Our second church is called Mom Connection. It's supposed to be single moms getting together on the first Saturday of each month to kind of support each other and have a nursery provided. Thank God. And they have a keynote speaker most of the time. So I'm kind of interested in that, and I want to see how that goes. Also, the vision board party that I'm planning on going to happens to be by ministry. So I'm kind of excited to meet new people when I go there, because I won't know anyone that's there unless I did invite people to go with me, but no one's actually agreed to go yet. So I'll probably be going by myself. Let's see. I want to have my deadline on prioritizing my well-being is July 2019. The reason I'm saying that, I just want it to be something that is in my regular routine by that point. Exploring new ways to fellowship. My deadline is March 2019. So yeah, I just want to be used to the idea by that point. I want to at least do one fellowship thing per month outside of the women's study at my church. I want to have 1,000 subscribers before December. I'm not really doing anything to change that other than posting my videos on my regular schedule. And I'm just going to actually keep up with the number of subscribers I get per month instead of just like making a mental note, oh yeah, I got a new subscriber, yay. I just want to, so that kind of equals out to, from where I'm at now, it equals out to about 50 subscribers per month. Another goal I have is to give RP one attention day per week. It's not that I don't give RP attention, but I just want to have one day a week where I don't have to do housework. I'm not focused on anything else. I just want to sit there with her, even if she wants to watch TV, where she has my full undivided attention. That's just something I want to do for her. And I want to have that in my routine before July. I want to enroll RP in some sort of class or social interaction. I really want her to be in school, but until I get a new job, that's not really going to be possible. We do have some subsidy programs, but it's really hard for me to find a daycare that actually accepts it. And yeah, that's that. So I want to put her in swimming. Most of the swimming classes don't start till like age 3. She's 2. So swimming, something like that, like kitty gymnastics, something just fun I want her to be able to do. So I gave my deadline August for that. Get out of the house more. I am a homebody. I literally go nowhere. I go to church, I go to work, and I come back home. If I don't do what I need to do on the way to those things or on the way back from those things, I'm not leaving to do it, go out of my way to do it. So deadline for that is June. So maybe I should go to more social events. Maybe I can go to more places with my brother or my god sister or my mom. Just some different stuff. It's a lot of stuff I want to go to, like around my hometown, but I always like plan it, but I don't actually go. Sundays, I want to actually observe, as you know, the way it's supposed to be. You don't do anything on the Lord's Day. So I want Sundays to be a no stress day. I actually want to be refreshed, renewed, and rejoicing on Sunday. So I'm giving myself to May to do that. And it's actually going pretty good with me doing that on Sundays so far. It's something I already started. I just wrote that down so it can stay in the front of my mind. I want to do yoga or meditation every morning. So my body has been naturally waking me up at 4:30 in the morning. So I'm kind of rolling with it. I started this week getting up at 4:30 in the morning. It has been amazing. I only did yoga on Monday, which was cool. And I did meditation the other days, which it was still good. The only thing I messed up today, which is Friday, is after I did my meditation, I went to sleep, like took a 10-minute nap. After that, I was just like, oh my gosh, I'm so sleepy. But if I would have just stayed up, I'd have been fine. My deadline on that is February. I want to draw, paint, or write something creative once a month. So drawing, I'm horrible at, but it's something that I like to do. When I took my art class in college, I actually, doing the projects they had us doing, it was really crazy, like, how great my work came out. And I kind of want to explore that and see how that goes. Because I never saw myself as a creative person, and I never saw myself as a person that could draw, paint, anything like that. And we did both of those things in my art class, so I'm really excited about that. And I write all the time anyway. It's just normally not anything really creative. I mean, I do my poetry, but my poetry is more like a journal, in my opinion. It's not just a creative work. So I'm giving myself till August for that. I want to have my $500 emergency fund for Dave Ramsey by July. I want to stick to my budget every month, so that's till December. And I want to take my trip to Austin this year. That's in October. It's an October deadline, but I want to go in August. I want a new job. My deadline is in August. I want to do 3 job applications per week, and I'm giving myself to August for that. So the reason I want to do only 3 job applications per week is because I have been doing job applications since 2016. I'm sick. When I say sick of it, all of it. So, once you do so many applications, you get to the point where, like, okay, if it's at the salary or if I meet the minimum requirements, I'm just applying. Because apparently nobody's calling me anyway, so I might as well just apply to everything so I can get out of where I am, that kind of thing. So what I want to actually do is read, like, literally read the job description. Be like, yes, yes, yes. Like, this sounds perfect. This sounds amazing. I qualify. I want to be passionate about the applications I put in. I want it to actually be a job I actually want to do. Because I was thinking, okay, I'm putting in all these applications to all these places, but just because I'm trying to get out of this place. But the next job I want to have, I literally want to have it for at least 5 years. I know for a fact. Hopefully longer than that, but you never know when you need to move, stuff like that. But at least 5 years. So I'm like, I'm applying to jobs I don't really care about. And what if I get stuck in those jobs for 5 years? Because, yeah, no. We're going to look for something that we really want to do, that we really like, and we're going to put in an application. We're going to do 3 a week. And I want to read 10 books this year. I'm giving myself to December. I know if I do 1 book a month till October, it'll be done. But, you know, you never know what'll happen. You might black out for a month. So I gave myself extra time. Okay, now I'm going to show you all what I did on my monthly, like, notes pages so I can keep up with my goals and see my current progress at all times. So this is how I set the notes page up before, like, each month. Some of the months I actually have a whole page in front of. Some of them I have no pages in front of. So I just, on the months where it was kind of like I didn't have, I just combined them. So I have my January monthly goals. For my quarterly, I have that I wanted to get a massage for the first quarter. So I have over here, did I complete it? A fellowship outing, I want to have one. So I got 1 out of 1. I put 1 out of 1. I want to get 50 new subscribers. So I have 50 as my goal over here. RP day, 1 per week. So that's 4. School research, I want to do that at least once a month. I want to no stress Sundays. I have 4 Sundays in a month. Yoga and meditation is 31 days in a month. So I can see, like, how many times it's actually being done that month. So then I can review January and go into February with different mindset. So one thing that's that I did do also is, let's see, go to a different one. I changed it from this little slash to the ratio because it was neater. So So on the when I get to the month where it's the deadline, what I do is I write, is it complete? So I can write yes or no. If it's not complete, I can add it to the next month and try again for that next month for it to be completed. So that's the way I'm gonna try to keep my mind focused on the goals, is because I actually have to keep up with it on these notes pages. So hopefully that turns out great, and let me know below in the comments what's you all's number one 2019 goal. You can tell me all of them, you can tell me one of them. Just make sure you all share with me. I'll be sure to comment back. Share as much as you like, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Okay, so this video is a collaboration with Elizabeth Ashley. She's on YouTube as well. I'll leave her link in the description box. Make sure you all go check out her 2019 goals video, and check out her other videos too, because oh my gosh, when I first started watching her videos, when I tell y'all, I was cracking up. And every time I start watching somebody else's new channel, I start all the way from their oldest videos and I like work my way up to the newer ones. And she had me laughing so hard. So I know she'll crack y'all up. Make sure y'all write in her comments. Let her know that I sent y'all there. And y'all have a great 2019.